actually never been to any Comic-Con, so it's, you know, I saw like this the sea of people, and I was like, oh my god, and everyone's dressed up, so it's been really cool so far. Yeah, so I play Happy Quinn. And she's one of the geniuses, and her specialty is machines. She's a mechanical engineer. And her role in the team, I guess as a team, we were hired by the government to solve problems. So her role is essentially being able to create and fabricate sort of any type of machinery to solve problems. I think a huge thing is you know, it's a group of individuals that have very different personalities. They're all unique in their own way, and I think that audiences are able to, you know, relate to at least one of the characters, and also the team aspect, I think, is really appealing to people. I love the cast. It's, you know, not only as the characters, but we're all very different, and we all bring something. It's a different type of energy, and we're all kind of odd in our own little way, but I think that that's what makes us get along so well. But yeah, we have a lot of fun on set working. I love the cast. It's, you know, not only as the characters, but we're all very different. And we all bring something. It's a different type of energy, and we're all kind of odd in our own little way, but I think that that's what makes us get along so well. But yeah, we have a lot of fun on set working.
Who's the most fun?
What I can say is Elias, who plays Walter O'Brien, and Robert Patrick are hilarious. They're just goofballs. It's just little things where, you know, we're rehearsing and they'll go off in different accents, and, you know, it's supposed to be maybe serious to some people, but it just kind of throws everyone off in a good way, for me anyway. I think that because, you know, especially in the beginning, like with the pilot, they sort of wanted to establish that, you know, she's guarded, she's protective of just everything. And I'm really happy that the showrunners have sort of included storylines where it allows her to reveal that side of her, you know, where it's like there is a reason why she walks around in the world like that, you know, why she's protective and why there's this need to protect and whatnot. And those, I guess, scenarios, you know, whether it's in one episode where, you know, Ralph is meeting his father, and, you know, everyone sort of has commentary about what Paige should or should not do. And for Happy, she doesn't say anything for the first little bit, but finally she actually, you know, gives her advice, and what forces her to do that is just her desire to not have Ralph experience the same experience she did. So that kind of revealed sort of that there is love, you know, in Happy. She shows it in a very different way. But it's those moments that I think are, they resonate because they're powerful in a sense, because it's not something that she normally chooses to do. I really, you know, Nick Santora, one of the showrunners, he had mentioned to me that he had thought about that particular scene where Happy goes to the garage and tells her father. Well, no, she tries to tell her father.
Because he knows.
Yes, and he had thought about that before we even started shooting. And I think for me, I'm really happy that throughout the whole season, there were, like, especially the first bit, there's inklings of her, I guess, experience with her father or like family history that you would kind of see like being emphasized but not thoroughly. And then sort of when they kind of kept on developing it, I don't know, I guess what I'm trying to say is I really liked that. I liked how there were certain episodes where their relationship was emphasized, because it does make up a whole, it makes up her, how she is, you know? So that was, yeah. You know, it's weird with like character breakdowns when they send them to you in auditions, but for me it was going, okay, yes, they've described her as this guarded person. And for me, I go, okay, well, why? And so when they tell me, oh, this is her upbringing, and, you know, this is kind of how, you know, she was abandoned and stuff like that. This is what happened to her mom, her father. And for me, it's like making sort of sense of okay, so this is how she is now. This was her background. Does it make sense? Or how can I sort of make it work? Or maybe it doesn't have to make sense at all. Yeah. She's based on this gentleman. He's about 50 or so years old. And I got a chance to briefly meet him, but I got to see photos of his workshop and just, you know, hear about some of the projects that he's involved with or has been. And I think it was just really fascinating to me. You know, I had this concept of what a mechanical engineer does. You know, I have lots of friends who are in school for that. But to sort of see these things that he created, I was like just blown away. I didn't know that that was possible. But yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, he is so generous in the sense that, you know, if I have questions, even now, he will gladly, you know, sit down or, you know, answer the phone, get me on the phone and just discuss those things. And for each episode, I think they have meetings just about, they go over, okay, this is what we're doing this episode. And he'll give his sort of expert advice about what is possible. You know, what can we conjure up to sort of not only add the entertainment, but like it bring some math and science to it as well, type thing. I really like Ari's character, Sylvester. He's a math genius and he's, you know, he's really anxious all the time, and I don't know, there's this like craziness about his space that I get, you know, to some degree. So that's, yeah, for him, that's that, yeah, Sylvester for now. I think that it's interesting because on one hand it's like, oh, maybe second season it'll evolve even more, you know, whatever direction that might be. But on the other hand, it's like if audiences are responding to what is happening with the show now, it's kind of like, is there a balance or you know, I'm not really sure, but in terms of what you said, it has progressed from like episode 1 to episode 22. So I think that, you know, as long as I feel like, you know, as long as I'm hoping that there will be more in-depth revealing of, like, each character's backstory, you know? I think that that's what audiences connect to. It's sort of like, let's get to know these guys a little bit more. So, yeah, maybe that. I don't know if there's going to be another one. That's not a question or information that I would get to know beforehand. It was fun. I mean, we actually shot that. We would shoot at their studio. You know, whenever I think Linda was involved. But it was cool. I think it's just nice to have different energy, and kind of see where that goes. I think it's, you know, this is all, as you had said, it's my first U.S. series. So I've never ever worked in the U.S. So that in itself is like new, and it's like, whoa, okay. So to add to what you're saying about, you know, CBS does really well with these procedurals and sort of like how that will look. You know, I'm just excited about what's going on right now. I don't really like to project too much into the future. But as long as it's, you know, people are responding and it's fun, I'm all for it. I remember the last few episodes that they were shooting, and every time I would get a script, I was like, how do they come up with this stuff? And then we'll get in, and I'm like, nothing's gonna, and the next one will top it. And I'm like, I don't know how you guys, you know, think of these things, and I don't even know where you're gonna go with it. Because, I mean, you look at the pilot with the airplane scene, and I'm just like, okay, so is that it? What's gonna happen now, right? But I have no idea if I don't know. I think it's just gonna be more explosions, perhaps, different versions of like cars, planes, boats. Who knows? Thank you so much for watching. We love it, and you know, you're the reason that we actually get to continue to do this for season 2.